Hi, I will show you what's new in the DrawXray. So let's add new empty mesh for retopo. Tab into edit mode and then from the left toolbar on the bottom search for DrawXray quads. So when you enable that, it may lag for a second or few depending how heavy your scene is, because it will calculate snapping cache. So shift F to resize, left click and drag to generate the quads. To see it better, enable the X-ray overlay from tool settings, or you can use the old way from 3D overlays in here. Okay, so the first new feature is that when I extend the stroke, I can scroll to resample that. So you can do something like that. And for example, if I draft the stroke in here, and then I can scroll in here, it will resize only the part after the weld. Then I can continue, scroll again, release mouse button. And now if I undo, you will see this will undo first the part after the weld, then it will undo the weld. So again, maybe if you remember in the past, the undo, there was option to undo individual faces, but it was not that useful. So it will undo up to weld, then undo the weld, then undo the rest. Another new feature is that you can select multiple edges and bridge them like that. And one limitation with this tool is that when I extend those edges, they will only bridge the ending. It won't bridge the parallel edges. So for that, only the single stroke has this ability. And if I extend this maybe to the left, I can resample that. And sometimes you can see the snapping does not look the best. This is not issue with the tool, but rather a limitation of the current snap mode. So sometimes you may need to switch from nearest projection to nearest snapping to the projected mapping. Just as a reminder, snapping is disabled for modeling with knife and grab tool, but it is still used for the dragging of the quads. So that means if I grab those verts, they are not snapped. But if I enable snapping for modeling, they will be now snapped to the surface. So anyway, let's see if there is much of the difference with projected mode. So it will project the verts from off low poly to high poly from the current viewport. So this usually will give you smoother and better results. The one limitation of this view projection is that when you move the stroke to the side at this kind of strong angle, the viewport projection may not look the best. Another limitation is when I use the wraparound functionality with Shift W. You see, this is not looking good, and you can see it was projected from the view. So for projection of those, you may switch back to the nearest mode. So Shift W again. Now it is wrapping around the arm correctly. You can scroll or control scroll like so. Left click to accept. And then finally, if you have this loop still selected, you can just left click and it will can extend that. So those are almost all the new features. There is also a button for smoothing, so you can quickly smooth this like so, or from the hotkey list you can use Shift Q. If you have the bundle with volume smoothing, then it will use the volume smoothing. If you don't have this, it will just fall back to the Blender Smooth. Okay, and maybe I can show you that, for example, in this area, let's extend this stroke slightly. And you see, this is snapping now to those spikes. So if you want, you can snap to just one object, and you will do this in the snap settings. So currently we are using global snap settings. In the global settings, we are snapping to all objects, but for this object, I want unique settings. So I will switch to unique per object settings, enable snapping projected, and rather than use all objects, I will snap to single object. I will pick the character body. And now when I draft, extend those edges and something like this. In this case, actually, using viewport projection is not the best, so I will use the nearest, and you see now it is not snapping to those spikes. And finally, the last feature is I will show you on the new low poly mesh. I want to show you what this 2D matching does. I will remove faces in here. And let me try to close this loop. And you see it is not really working. It is not working because from this point of view, you see those edges are not really parallel. This is often issue on more bumpy high poly meshes like this character. So for example, this face may look flat, but from the side you see this is not really flat. And those edges may not be really too parallel. And to solve this issue, we can use screen space. And you can do this by enabling 2D matching. Maybe the name is not the best, but the idea is if two edges look parallel from the current point of view, they will be used for bridging the faces. For smoother, high poly characters, usually there is no need for this 2D matching. And that's basically it. So you can see the hotkey is in here. Mostly you will use just left click and draw. I can maybe show you a bit of modeling on the face. So let's do a bit of retopology. Let's do the eyes now. And maybe Shift Q to smooth out. And I want to extend this loop around. And it does not look the best. So again, sometimes you have to juggle the snapping settings. I know that projected will work better in this case. Something like this look okay. So the idea with this tool is that you just define the main loops first, and then you bridge and fill the holes in between those main loops. And this low poly mesh has mirror with clipping, so when I snap to center, it will kind of glue those verts with the clipping option from mirror. So I can get maybe something like this. And I want to pay attention around the mouth area. So I will move those a bit manually in here. And let's do the mouth loop. Something like this maybe. Looks good enough. Then I want to do the loop around the nose. Something like this. Scroll to add extra loop in here. Maybe something like that. And maybe fill this like so. Here. Fill this. It's kind of booked out. But okay, we get this. Looks okay. Then we get something like this. We can get something like this. Maybe smooth this with Shift Q. And snap those verts to the center. And I want this loop to go to the center. So something like that. And okay, so I want this loop to go in here, but we get two faces. So I will subdivide this. And do something like that, like this, and like this. And in here I will just merge those two. Where is the merge button? So we get something like this, Shift Q to smooth out the stuff. And it may be look easy when I do this because I know the limitation of this tool. And one limitation is the more close gaps, close holes like that you have, the easier it will be to breach and close those holes with this tool, because it will try to snap everywhere at once, so we may get crappy results. So I know for this kind of hole, you will not do not want to start from a big edge, because a big edge will make the brush bigger and it will snap everywhere. So instead, you may want to start from smaller edge like this one, but maybe go in this direction. Or you may just want to maybe use F2 and fill this like so. So it all depends. And let's maybe we'll remove this loop. And okay, so now welding of this doesn't work because we have small brush, because this is small edge and this is too wide. So we'll just make them bigger. Then I could shift Q to smooth this out, delete this edge, make this in here, maybe extend this, and in here this. I could maybe collapse some edges like that, and extend this in here, this in here, and hopefully you get the idea. So maybe I could go like that and like that, match those, or maybe it will be easier to go like that. Something like this, maybe. Probably the topology won't be the best, but maybe it will be good enough. So maybe we have too many loops in here. I could collapse this one and maybe do something like this. I don't know, it doesn't look too good, but I do not want to spend too much time on this part. Well, maybe try something better like this here, and let's try something like that, and I could smooth this out. So I guess this should give you idea about the workflow with this tool. Hope you like this update, and see ya.